Chapter 6. Mousetrap. Another visit. Anybody home? The door wasn't locked, so I... Huh? Mala, why are you crying? No, I don't know. I tell you, I'm at my wit's end. What now? Your father, he treats me as if I were just a maid or his nurse. Worse! At least a maid has some days off and gets paid. He only gives me $50 a month when I need a pair of stockings. I have to use my own savings. Well, he hasn't changed. Whenever I needed school supplies or new clothes, Mom would have to plead and argue for weeks before he'd cough up any dough. When I try to argue with him, he moans like he's going to have another heart attack. I can't be sure if he's faking, so I have to stop. I feel like I'm in prison. I feel like I'm going to burst. I'm going to go get some juice. Want some? No. I'll tell you something. When we first got married, I needed clothes. It was a year and a half after Anya died. He took me to her closet and said, "All these are for you." I said I wouldn't touch her things. My God, how that man carried on. I swear, sometimes I think he married me because I'm the same size as Anya. He's always been, pragmatic. Pragmatic? Cheap. It causes him physical pain to part with even a nickel. Uh-huh. I used to think the war made him that way. Ah, I went through the camps. All our friends went through the camps. Nobody is like him. It's something that worries me about the book I'm doing about him. In some ways, he's just like the racist caricature of the miserly old Jew. Ha! You can say that again. I mean, I'm just trying to portray my father accurately. Even for himself, he doesn't spend any money. He has hundreds of thousands of dollars in the bank, and he lives like a pauper. Look, he grabs paper towels from the restroom so he won't have to buy napkins or tissues. I wish I got Mom's story while she was alive. She was more sensitive. It would give the book some balance. Your mother. I just don't know how she could stand living with him. I don't know how I can stand it. So, hi, kids. I didn't know you were upstairs here. I was watering downstairs the garden. Mala and I were just talking about my book. I've already started to sketch out some parts. I'll show you. See, here are the black market Jews they hanged in Sosnowick. Ah. And here's you saying, ah, when I think of them, it still makes me cry. Yes, still it makes me cry. It's an important book. People who don't usually read such stories will be interested. Yes, I don't read ever such comics, and even I am interested. Of course, you are interested. It's your story. Yes, I know already my story by heart, and even I am interested. It should be very successful. Yeah, someday you'll be famous, like, what's his name? Huh? Famous like what's his name? You know, the big shot cartoonist. What cartoonist could you know? Walt Disney? Yeah, Walt Disney. Wait, where do you go, Artie? To get a pencil. I've just got to write this conversation down before I forget it. Come, we'll all of us go to the garden. You'll see how nice it looks, the bushes. You go. I've got to get ready. I have an appointment at the hairdresser's. Again to the hairdresser? Only a week ago you went. She sees more often the hairdresser than she sees me. You see how it is? Anytime I want to go out for a few minutes, he tries to make me feel guilty. I'm supposed to be at his constant beck and call. What I said that's so terrible. Believe me, you'd have more fresh air from the garden than from 100 hairdressers. Oi, Vladek, stop it. You see how she is? What I have to do with her? Come on, Pop. Let's go sit in the garden. If I say only one word to her, she makes right away an argument. She says she wants to leave me. I tell her, so, here is the door. But remember, it's only one way. If you go out, you can't come back. Maybe you should both see a marriage counselor. Ah, I don't want that a stranger should mix into our private stories. To a lawyer, I talked years ago, and right away he warned me, Vladek, watch out. I see this woman is money conscious. And once Mala and I sat with Aunt Helen to help agree us for a new will. But a month after, Mala wanted again to change it. Don't see a therapist about your will. Talk about how to get along better. With Mala, it's not to get along. Only it's the money. I give up. I don't know what to say. You see? I also don't know what to say. Look, I can't stay long. I need to know more about you and Anya. It's chilly. Take also here a blanket. No thanks. What happened in 1944, after you left Thrajula? We sneaked towards Sosnowick. It was still dark outside. We didn't know where to hide ourselves. Janina lives over there. Richow's governess always offered she would help us. We came to her house near town. Open up, Janina, quick! Who's there? My God, it's the Spiegelmans! You'll bring trouble. Go away, quickly! Slam! I'm frightened, Vladek. Maybe we should try my father's old house. The janitor has known our family for years. Let's try. We've got to get off the streets before dawn. I was a little safe. I had a coat and boots, so like a Gestapo wore when he was not in service. But Anya, her appearance, you could see more easy she was Jewish. I was afraid for her. Wake up, Mr. Lukowski. Let us in, please. Huh? Who is it? Anya! Anya Zylberberg! What are you doing here, child? It isn't safe. Wait, I'll unlock the gate. Go through the courtyard to the shed. I'll bring you some food. Thank God there are still some kind people left. I thought, a Jewess! An old witch recognized Anya from her window. There's a Jewess in the courtyard! Police! Hurry! We ran fast to the shed and hid in the straw. It's okay for now. I don't think anyone heard her. She's a little senile anyway. But you must look for a better place to stay. Someone here is bound to recognize you. It's almost morning. Wait here. I'm going out to scout around. But be careful. I walked, but I didn't know where to go. And I heard soon it was somebody following behind me. I walked slow. Behind me also walked slow. I walked fast. Behind me also walked fast. We were alone. He spoke. Amcha? In Hebrew, he said to me, our nation? I had to answer him, or no. Amcha, I thought you were a Jew. I'm Jewish, too. There are very few of us left. My wife and I have been hiding in Sosnowick for over a year. I'm with my wife, too. We're hungry, and we need a place to hide. Go to the black market on Dakota Street, number 8. So I left him and went right away to Dakota 8. There was a big courtyard. All around I looked, but it was nobody. Psst! Want to buy some food without coupons, mister? She showed to me sausages, eggs, cheese, things I only was able to dream about. I bought and went quickly back to Anya. Good morning. Vladek, you were gone so long. I had to get breakfast. Want some sausages or eggs? Or would you prefer chocolate? What? It's a miracle. How did you manage it? I'm a magician. Have some milk. I went again back to Dakota. There I could change jewelry for marks and marks for food or a place to stay. This time it was more people. There even I saw some Jewish boys I knew from before the war. Vladek Spiegelman? I hardly recognized you. So you're still alive, eh? Leo, yes, I'm with Anya. We need a hiding place. How about Mrs. Kauka? She has a small farm on the outskirts of town. She might take you in if you can pay. It was not so far to go to Kauka's farm. All right then, Mr. Spiegelman, you and your wife can stay in my barn. We'll come late tonight. But remember, if you're found there, I don't know you. You must say that the barn door was open and you just sneaked in. Don't worry, we won't betray you.